It's February 24th, which is Selection Sunday for the Point O women's basketball team, as they gather together to find out whether or not they would receive one of the 7 at-large bids for the NCAA Division Three tournament. At 24-3, the Pointers felt they had a good chance to get in, but were unsure following their loss to UW Oshkosh in the semifinals of the WIAC Conference Tournament. They sat in anticipation, awaiting their fate. Pointers knocked off Lake Forest 88-52 in the first round and advanced to play WashU, the number one ranked team in the nation and four-time defending national champion. Behind a strong offensive performance from Carrie Banning and a tough defensive effort, this layup from Andrea Kramer sealed the deal.
Puts up the layup and it's good. Pointers got a 6-point lead with 4.4 seconds left. The Pointers are going to win this game. It's over! The Pointers have ended the 70-game winning streak at home of the Washington University Bears. The Pointers are victorious. They have shocked NCAA Division III world. The Pointers have done it.
The 66-60 win catapulted the Pointers to the Sweet 16, which they played before a sellout crowd at the Berg Gymnasium. By knocking off Webster 71-61, they advanced to the Elite Eight to take on Pacific Lutheran for a chance to go to the Final Four. Leading by only 2 at halftime, the Pointers outscored Pacific Lutheran 37-22 in the second half behind Kerry Groshek's 16 points and 8 rebounds to win 64-47 and advance to the Final Four in Terre Haute, Indiana. On Wednesday, March 13th, the Pointers embarked on their journey with a 7-hour bus trip to Terre Haute, Indiana. After arriving in Terre Haute and having a team dinner, the Pointers headed back to the hotel to rest up for Thursday, a day which would be filled with practice and preparation for their Final Four matchup against Marymount of Virginia. Even though practice doesn't begin until 11:30, the team gets to Hulbert Arena an hour earlier, so trainer Jen Zinn has time to treat them. Players do different things during this time to keep themselves busy.
Good morning, this is Diane Hawkins reporting for STV News. I'm here live at Rose Holman Center. And today we're going to perform a blind smell test on Nahuda's shoes. Nick here is going to perform the impossible by being our first person to smell them. All right, Nick, close the eyes.
I think I'm ready.
Shoe number one.
Oh. Okay. Yep, that was kind of bad, yeah.
Nick, how did it smell?
Not real great. I guess you'll have to compare it with the second one, though.
Okay, shoe number two.
Okay, that's got to be the left one.
Okay, yay! Nick, so the verdict is shoe number two?
The left shoe number two definitely smelled worse.
All right. Now we have Justice Cleveland here to take the shoe test also.
Scared. Dan?
Shoe number one.
What am I doing?
Okay, that's enough. Justice, how did that smell?
That was quite fragrant.
Shoe number two.
Holy cow.
Wait, let's get that again.
I said holy cow, it smells like Iowa.
Oh, man.
What? Should we take the ones off my feet?
No, Nahuda, no. Nahuda can't even bear the smell of her own feet.
Who's next? Just do it.
I'm not smelling your dang shoes. I'm smarter than that. Hey, coach. Coach Egner, how did the press conference go this morning? That's a new question, by the way.
Yeah, still,
Okay, fine. I'll get a new question for the next interview.
All right. It went very well.
Is that it?
Well, that was the answer to your question.
Did all four coaches sit together during the press conference?
No.
Oh.
But we were all in the same room at the same time.
How did that make you feel?
There's that question, Hawkins.
I told you, next interview.
I was fine. Nothing to be intimidated about. We got the pointers.
That's right. So, what do you think of the facility here?
Beautiful.
I know.
It's really nice. Looking forward to playing.
All right, thank you.
After an hour of waiting, the pointers are finally allowed into the arena to practice. This will be the same floor they'll play on for the final four.
You guys, the fans start coming through.
I think my backpack is off.
Coach Agner gets her team working hard early. Wrap up practice and head back to the hotel. They'll have all afternoon off and are free to do whatever they want.
I think I might, you know, take a walk maybe over to Old Navy by our hotel, but, you know.
Yeah. We have Old Navy by our hotel, and I don't think I've been so excited my entire life. Also, there's a mall across the street.
Oh, yeah, there is.
So you go there.
Bonus.
It's going to be a good day. Then tomorrow, down to business. No more fun.
Maybe I'll sit in my room and study for COM 171, because Professor Kelly, I am going to be studying for this test. And I appreciate you letting me take it on Monday.
I also have a test on Monday, a Biology 100 lab exam. I don't have a clue what's on it. All I know is I got to start reading, because it's already Thursday.
This is Diane Hawkins, Andrea Kramer, and a little 2 cents from Amanda Nahuda signing off. Have a good day.
At 6 p.m., the team will meet to go to the championship banquet at the Hallman Memorial Union.
I'm excited about the banquet tonight. It's going to be some darn good food. And I haven't had good food. Well, actually, I've had good food, but...
What are you wearing?
Oh, my gosh. This is the dilemma of the week.
I don't know what to wear to this thing.
I know.
I really don't know what to wear.
I should have brought my prom dress.
I really should. I don't know what to wear to this banquet.
I really don't
know what to wear. I have so many outfits.
I know.
Huda, what are you wearing?
I am wearing my black pants with one of Kramer's 5 shirts that I brought with me. I'm not quite sure which one. Maybe I'll model them all for you later on. It took me 1 hour to find 5 shirts that I like, but now I can't figure out which one to wear.
I brought one outfit so I would not have a dilemma on what to wear.
I have 2 outfits. I have one of Huda's belts, and I'm thinking about wearing it, but I'm not exactly sure.
After the banquet on Thursday night and an early Friday morning practice, the pointers board the bus as they prepare to head to the Hulbert Arena on the Rose-Hulman campus. At 6 o'clock, they will take on Marymount of Virginia for the right to play in the national championship game.
Holla back, youngin'.
This is John Kemmeter for STV. couple hours ahead of tip-off here as the Pointers get ready for their Final Four matchup against Marymount of Virginia. Winner advantage of the championship game. It's a great atmosphere here, as you can see around the court. People are starting to trickle in. You got the workers coming around here setting up things. I think the fans will probably be able to come in about a half hour or so, about an hour before the game time. Definitely a great scene here. And there's lots of Pointer fans that came down to support the women's basketball team. And we talked to a few of them outside the arena.
It's going to be a battle, I believe. It's going to be a battle, but I think the Pointer girls are going to be a W at the end of the game.
Definitely some competitive basketball tonight.
That team we're playing has got that preseason All-American, but I think we're going to shut her down inside. We're going to go inside early and often, early and often.
What are you guys going to think about the atmosphere here? Are you going to make it like a home game for the women out there?
As much as we can.
Might as well.
We're going to try.
It's going to be a classic game, just like the Pointer Gym. Bird Gym all over again.
Definitely.
You can definitely start to feel a little buzz for about, an hour and a half or so before game time, and you can start to feel it. It's starting to get a little electricity in the air, starting to get that Final Four feel.
Around the same time, the media was getting set up as well. All right, we're here with Dan Meerman from 90FM, also the Pointer, also a little STV work, but today he'll be handling the duties for 90FM. What are your thoughts on this game today, Dan?
It should be a great game. I'm just looking forward to watching Point do what they do best. I think Carrie Groshek's going to have a huge game. I think Carrie Banning's going to have a huge game as well. And I don't know, I think they're going to be too tough for Marymount on this evening.
Kind of describe your duties, what you got to do before the game. We got about an hour to go. What do you have to do to get ready for a broadcast?
I just got to go over my notes, make sure that everything is, you know, in order that I can get to it instead of just being buried somewhere in my backpack. And then I got to make sure that Jesse doesn't talk too much to me while I'm on the air.
Jesse Horn. You're sitting next to him, right?
Yeah, I am.
I'm going to be just kind of sitting at the scorer's table watching the game.
I'll have various duties during this event. I'll be covering the game for the Portage County Gazette, and I'll also be updating the score on our webpage via our laptop system so people back home who aren't able to listen on the radio will be able to check in periodically on the internet and find out with that. Also be taking some pictures so we're able to have those for our experience.
At 5:22, the Pointers were able to take the court and begin pregame warm-ups. Looking at me, I can tell by your eyes that you're feeling me. And I really want you to get close to me. So would you dance with me, dance with me. My drop top's in the parking lot, and I'm gonna take you back to my spot. But we still got a little more time to rock. So would you dance with me, dance with me. I see you looking at me, I can tell by your eyes that you're feeling me. And I really want you to get close to me. So would you dance with me, dance with me. Pointers get rolling from the jump. Carrie Banning getting the tip from Carrie Groshek up ahead to Amy Schultz for the lane. Pointers knocking down the jumpers early from the wing. Tara Schmidt, that's good. Later on, top of the key, Cassandra Hoyer. 4-3, Pointers lead 17-8 in the first half. Amy Schultz this time from the corner knocks down the three. Pointers going to the locker room ahead 33-25. In the second half, Pointers continue to frustrate All-American guard Candace Brown as she finished with 2 points. And 1-for-11 shooting. Carrie Banning getting the ball inside. They build a 48-31 lead. Defensive pressure continues. Hoyer here getting the steal and the timeout. Pointers roll in the second half. They win 80-57 and advance to the Division III National Championship game. Coach Egner talked about our team's performance.
But I think our defense was the difference in the game. It's been our staple all year. It's what feeds into our offense. They tried to play us in a zone, and then they went to that triangle in two, I believe. And we had some success with it early, hit some jump shots, but then I thought we got a little jump shot happy instead of getting the ball inside to our big kids. Second half, we tried to run a little bit more, open up the offense, get a little bit more movement, and obviously we got to the free throw line a whole bunch of times. And if we're going to try to win a national championship tomorrow night, we definitely are going to have to shoot better than 23-for-40 from the line. Rebounding, I thought we did a great job. Groshek was an animal, getting 15 boards. And we just worked really hard, 22 minutes, had 15 rebounds. But I think our success came from our defense tonight. Defense is what we build our program on. And we've got more than one person that can play solid defense, and we were willing and ready to put Kramer, Nahuda, and Hoyer on her. So we had three people that we felt that could contain her. you know, not to be so bold to say, yeah, I thought we could hold her to 2 points, but I knew we'd make it difficult for her to score points. She was our main focus, her and 44, and I thought we did a great job with them throughout the whole game.
Coach Egner also talked about our team's matchup in the championship game.
What are some of the things you look into as you head into the game tomorrow?
Well, first of all, we got to figure out what opponent we're going to be playing. And, you know, we just want to take care of business. You know, we showed them a little bit tonight, probably more than what we wanted to show, but we needed to be able to adapt to what they were doing out there on the floor. And we got everybody in the game. We got some kids some rest. So hopefully we'll have enough gas left in our tank to go out there and do battle tomorrow night.
Talk about the balance on your team from an offensive standpoint. You got a number of players off the bench came up and contributed.
That's been our strength all year, John. You know, we've had different kids lead us in scoring, you know, different nights out on the floor, and that's a great asset to our team. We're very deep, and our kids are very unselfish, and it's just a real pleasure to coach these kids because they don't care who scores the points. They care that we have more points at the end of the game than our opponent.
Hey, we're here with Carrie Benning. Carrie, congratulations on the big win tonight. How does it feel to be finally going to the ship?
To finally be going to the ship, it's awesome. I don't even think words can describe how I'm feeling.
Talk about where you guys come since you were a freshman. Now you're a senior. You've seen this kind of fulfill into the championship game now.
We have come a long way. Coming in as a freshman, I think we probably maybe had like 30 fans in the stands. And, you know, we were always like the 500 team. And our coaches did a great job recruiting, and we had a lot of talent, and we finally put it together this year.
After watching the first half of the St. Lawrence DePaul game, the team gets back on the bus and heads to the hotel, where there will be a reception for them put on by UWSP alumni and university relations.
When we get back to the hotel, you need to go to where that reception is for a little while. Not for a long while. Yes, you can stay there, but just not till wee hours in the night.
In the morning.
It's a Wednesday.
Starts at 10:30 and like... It's a room called the Chestnut Room. You go to the lobby and look for the banquet room, the Chestnut Room.
Coach Egner also discussed his plans for the next day.
Now, listen please. We need to be here at 10:30 with your little warm-up jackets on for this autograph session. Okay?
Who are we autographing for?
They're putting on a clinic in the morning from 8:30 until 10:30. And then all four teams will be sitting at tables or walking around or something with little kids coming up to you and asking you for your autographs. Okay? It's from 10:30 until 11.
And you should say yes.
I see. We're going to be heartless.
Okay, now here's the decision you need to make. From 10:30 until 11, we need to do autograph. Okay? We don't have our walkthrough until 1, and we're going to have to walk through. It'll be a little bit more than it was last Saturday, just because they're giving us a tape tonight, so I'll be able to be more thorough with the scouting report for tomorrow. Okay, so we need to decide from 11 to 1 what we're gonna do. You don't need to decide now.
We can't go far. This training room is
gonna be. Oh, you're gonna do hair. Okay.
Training.
And then the other thing that you need.
Training room means an hour.
The other thing you need to decide is where you want to do pregame tomorrow, so we can call and make reservations.
I think.
I understand.
Olive Garden.
You guys decide.
Megan. Between 11 and 12.
Are we doing hair at the gym?
That's your call. The training room. Yeah. The training room needs to be here by noon. So really, we have an hour.
So really,
we're probably going to be staying.
Before heading to the reception, the team stops off at Burger King for a post-game snack. Pointer fans showed up at the Chestnut Room in the Holiday Inn in Terre Haute for the post-game reception. It is a chance for the large number of fans who made the roughly 7-hour journey to hang out with the team and celebrate their victory.
To everybody that be living it up, we say,
what do I do?
No, get out, no cameras, come on.
After breakfast, the Pointers head to the Rose Holman SRC Fieldhouse, where they will sign autographs to participants in a basketball clinic. Here they're signed for fans young and old. The Pointers are led into the gym and begin their hour-long practice in preparation for Saturday night's championship game. They will face St. Lawrence University of New York, who defeated DePaul University of Indiana 69-54 on Friday. The Saints of St. Lawrence are led by point guard number 5, Meredith Eisenhut, the Division III Player of the Year. At the end of practice, Coach Aidner goes over individual scouting reports for St. Lawrence.
Point of emphasis, do not allow 5 to get to the free throw line. Don't fail to run. Rebound basketball, be ready for the pressure. You're going to come after us, we can run with the best of them. Okay? Don't worry about that. All right, 5. You got 150 steals. Yeah. Okay, she's gonna come after, she's gonna reach. She gets her skills to open court because she sure doesn't want to have her defense. She gets her head turned, loses vision. Okay?
She reaches on a change. She reaches on a point all the time with a long hand.
Into your body.
Her shoulder.
Okay? 14, that number didn't come out. It's 14, not 4. She's left-handed. Okay? 20. She got 54 blocks. 54 blocks. Okay, 30. She got 42 blocks. 5 rebounds, 5.5 rebounds. Now look at their post players. Assist to turnover. I don't know what our post player assist to turnover ratio, but I know it's got to be better than that. Get out and pressure the ball, post players. That's why we play shell drill every day. Get out and pressure the ball. Okay, 13. Decent shooter. Those numbers are what they had last night. So 5 head. 14 points, 4 rebounds. Okay? 17-2, 13-8. So on. Look at the numbers. And again, they don't mean squat. Get to this bar. Throw the numbers out. Okay? I expect for them to play as full court man. I expect for them to face guard us. I expect for them to try to turn the ball over, similar to Webster. Press break, okay? Full court man, press break. Throw the ball in, either one or two, clear out, get the heck out of there, bring it up. They don't run and jump. They just make it, you remember, I don't know if you were out here from the beginning of the game last night, they made it extremely hard for the ball to get the ball in a couple of times. It's in our backcourt, we set up box. Get up there, yes, get out, and get the thing in. Just don't leave one person back there to try to get the ball in. Post players, they play on the top side, they lean on you, and they bring help from the weak side. It's not necessarily post to post, especially if we're running motion offense with our post player up high. So the weak side guard is going to come in to double. We're going to run motion, and I want us running post-entry and, more importantly, dribble entry, because they go underneath that pick and roll. They don't defend the pick and roll very well at all. And they're going to get out and pressure us. They play defense a lot like us. They get out and they pressure, and that leaves it one-on-one in the post.
After practice, the team will go out for lunch and then head back to the hotel, where they'll have 3 hours off, until the boss picks him up again to take him to the championship game.
It's ship time, baby!
Throw your hands in the air if you's a true player.
Just the honeys getting money, playing fellas like dummies. You got a gun up in your waist, please don't shoot up the place.
Wow.
Cause I see some ladies tonight that should be having my baby. Baby.
The Pointers' mantra all postseason long has been that they just want to play. It didn't matter who or where, they just wanted to keep on playing. Tonight, no matter what happens, will be their last game this season. This is what it all boils down to, the national championship game. The game will also be the last in the Pointer uniform for three seniors, Kerry Baining, Kerry Groshek, and Amy Schultz. The Pointers' starting lineup is announced with Baining and Schultz at forward, Groshek at center, and sophomores Tara Schmidt and Andrea Kramer at guards. The women huddle up for one last time as they get ready for action. It's finally time to start the national championship game, and the Saints win the opening tip. Much of the focus for the Pointers defensively is controlling guard Meredith Eisenhut and not allowing her to get to the foul line. On St. Lawrence's second possession, she is fouled and will shoot two. However, she will attempt only two other free throws the rest of the game. Pointers get the high-low game working early. Kerry Groshek off the glass and the foul. Later on in the first half, shot clock winding down. Andrea Kramer gets a three to fall. Pointers up early. Tara Schmidt playing some tough defense. Out-hustling Eisenhut to the ball. Scoops it up and drives in for the uncontested layup. But St. Lawrence would hang tough. Kara Barbieri from the wing for three, and that's good. Here's Kerry Baining. Gets the defenders to buy on the old pump fake. Gets it in. She led the Pointers 11 points at halftime as they're up 37-25 over St. Lawrence and only 20 minutes away from a national title. Second half, Cassandra Hoyer, top of the key for three, and that's good. St. Lawrence would come back, though. Jessica Zook gets the basket here and is fouled. Later on, off the Eisenhut miss, Eliza Bogdanich follows as the Saints cut the Pointer lead to one with 5.5 to go. A little over a minute to go. Pointers up by one. Cassandra Hoyer gets that one to go. 14 seconds left. Megan Dietrichson from the baseline. No good. Andrea Kramer with the rebound, and she's going to be fouled. Go to the free throw line to shoot two. After missing the first one, here's her second attempt.
Second one's up, and good. 4-point lead for the Pointers. Just 9.5 seconds left. Hutchinson will drive up. Pointers are going to let her, they're going to let her shoot it. Three-pointer. Miss. Rebounded. It's up and good. 1 second left. Pointers up by 2 points. Quick timeout by the St. Lawrence bench.
With 1 second left, all the Pointers have to do is inbound the ball safely, and they'll win. Coach Eggener uses a timeout to draw up a play. Senior Amy Schultz will inbound the ball from underneath the basket.
Inbound deep, taken away. Shot. Does it go? Pointers win the championship. The Pointers win the championship. Your Stevens Point Pointers are NCAA Division Three champions. The Pointers win it.
As Barbieri's shot is off the mark, the Pointers celebrate with a 67-65 victory. With the win, UW-Stevens Point becomes just the eighth school in Division III history to win 30 games in a season. It is also the 200th win in head coach Shirley Eggener's career. The team lines up for the award ceremony.
Yeah.
Sophomore guard Terrace Schmidt is named to the all-tournament team. Schmidt had 9 points versus Marymount and finished with 5 points, 8 assists, and 3 steals in the championship game. Senior forward Kerry Baining is named the tournament most valuable player. After scoring 9 points and hauling in 7 rebounds versus Marymount, she added 15 points and 6 rebounds versus St. Lawrence to help lead the Pointers to the title. Schmidt also limited Division III Player of the Year Meredith Eisenhut to 5 points and had more turnovers 4 than assists 3, while Schmidt only turned the ball over once in her 2 Final 4 games.
I paid my dues.
NCAA Division III Women's Championship.
Yeah.
Where are you going?
Probably to be a shower first. After that, I'm going to Disney World. Yeah!
As the women were in the locker room following their win, bus driver Dean Will talked about the bus ride to the arena earlier in the day.
Well, on our way here today for practice, Shirley was riding up front with me. There was one of the other team buses ahead of us and one behind us. When we came around the corner, got off the highway, and we went through 1, 2, 3, 4 stoplights. The other two buses had to stop for stoplights. Our bus was lucky enough not to have to stop. We hit green lights all the way. And I looked over at Shirley and I said, we're gonna win tonight because we're lucky, the other ones aren't. We hit all green lights.
The team eats pizza on the bus as they head to TGI Fridays, where there'll be a championship celebration with family and friends.
Please. Last time, I'm going to ask for your attention tonight. Get up. We want to be rolling at 9 a.m. The question is, you want to stop at like McDonald's for breakfast on our way out of town and then go, or don't? You'll take care of your own breakfast, or what? I need to know about breakfast.
I would say just plan on stopping. Whoever feels up enough to eat, then they can stop.
Yeah, exactly.
Can you hear me now? Hooter reporting for the UW Stevens Point women's basketball team on STV. Anyway, do we see this? What is this? You might say it's not a boat. It looks like a speedboat. What is it?
A ship!
Okay, this is the UW Stevens Point ship. Floating nicely around, right? St. Lawrence ship sunk. Sorry to say it, but...
Ouch!
We won the ship!
We won the ship!
What?
We won the ship! What? We won the ship! What?
We won the ship!
What?
We won the ship!
What?
That's all I had to say. I'm sorry.
Gotta say.
Signing
off. Peace!
At the half, but St. Lawrence battled back. Eliza Bogdanich, if that's how you say it, the rebound.
It's not.
The second to play. They get the steal and the shot for the win. No good. Great drama. The Flyers are
To cap off the celebration, Amy Schultz and STV's own Justice Cleveland jumped in the Holiday Inn pool for the big splash.
You know what, you guys? I didn't record at all. I didn't record. You guys want to do it again? We're joking.
Chelsea,
you
got to do it again.
Come on, one more time.
Shoot the good word tomorrow.
One more time.
I wanted to take
one. One more time.
One more time.
Hey, come here, come here.
My goal is to expand.
What do you guys do this for?
National champions.
We're doing the big splash because we're national champions.
My clothes have expanded four times their own weight.
Do it again.
One, two, three.
Big splash.
I am number one. No matter if you like it or take it, sit down and write it. I am number one.
After a 7-hour bus ride back to Stevens Point, the national champion Pointer women's basketball team was welcomed back by fans at the Berg Gymnasium.
I am number one. What does it take to be number one? Two is not a winner, and three nobody remembers. What does it take to be?
UWSB Chancellor Tom George talked about the team.
You know, you go back in the beginning of the season and just, you know, a national championship is very, very difficult to achieve. Extremely difficult. I mean, it's very difficult for the best of teams. You've got to have outstanding players, outstanding coaches. Everything has to fall into place. It doesn't happen that often. It's extremely difficult, and we did it. We did it here at Stevens Point.
I was once told that I should surround myself with good people, and I think I've done that with David and Sean. And then my players, my seniors, this is one reason why I don't talk at senior day. I love you three. You've done exactly what we've asked you to do. You've been pillars for us. And You've been great leaders, and our underclassmen have learned from you, and they will carry on what you have built, and I'm so thankful that you chose to come to Point, and I love you. I think Kramer showed Marymount University what defense is all about. I think Tara Schmidt showed Meredith what it's like to go against one of the best players of the year. We wouldn't be standing here, sitting here, half awake, being 30-3 without every one of these kids out here. They understand their role. They fulfill their role every day of practice. Sometimes they don't like it. Sometimes they get tired of listening to me bitch at them. But they don't have to hear that again until next August or September. September, I guess. But I'm really proud of them. They worked extremely hard. Chancellor said we needed to have a little luck and have things fall into place, and you do. And it's just unbelievable.
Seniors Kerry Groshek, Amy Schultz, and Carrie Baining each got their turn at the podium.
I just want to say thanks to everyone for this year and the last four. This has been a dream come true for me, and there's no way I could have ended it any better than what we've done. And I want to thank all you guys too, because you guys are great, and I'll miss you a lot next year. And Coach, thank you. Both, all three of you, thanks. That's it. Bye.
I would just like to thank all my teammates and coaches for everything. You guys are the greatest. We won't be here without all of you. Thanks to all the fans for all your support. It's been wonderful. Thanks.
I'm going to start out by saying thanks to all the fans for all your support. We couldn't have done it without you. A couple years ago, we didn't have as many people in this gym. I want to thank my coaches for everything, for recruiting me. I couldn't have imagined my senior year any better. And I couldn't have done it without my teammates. You guys are my family, my second family. I love you. Just thanks to everyone.
Junior Megan Hodson, who was out with a knee injury, talked about the NCAA tournament experience.
Forever. Some people come into our lives and quickly go. Some people move our souls to dance. Some people awaken us with a new understanding of their wisdom. Some people make the skies more beautiful to gaze upon. And because some people's footprints mark our hearts, we are never, ever the same. Going into this weekend, I just wanted them all to know that it was an unforgettable experience, one that there are kids, high school athletes, college men and women around the nation that would love to be in their shoes. And I wanted them to know that I was one of them, that I would have given anything to step on that floor in a uniform, knowing that I was about to participate in the NCAA championship game. I'm really proud of what these guys did, and this has nothing to do with what my speech was on Saturday night, but it was awesome just being there, and I know many of you know that. It was just awesome to watch these guys compete. And I told them what one of their responsibilities were to accept the special gifts that they have been given and to use those gifts to help those people that looked up to them. And I close by telling them, thank you, Mom, for moving my soul to dance, never-ending dance, for making the sky more beautiful for me to gaze upon. And because these guys' footprints mark my heart, I'll never be the same.
Can see clearly.
if anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope, when my back's against the ropes, I can feel it, I'm the world's greatest. I am a giant, I am an eagle, oh, I am a lion down in the jungle. I am a marching band, I am the people, oh, I am a helping hand, I am a hero. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, I'm that star up in the sky, I'm that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope, when my back's against the ropes, I can feel it, I'm the world's greatest.
In the ring of life, I'll rain love,
I will rain,
and the world will notice. Greatest,
I'm that little bit.
I'm that little bit.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Against the
world,
I can feel it.
Feel it.
I'm the world's greatest.
Whoa.
I'm that star up in the
star
sky.
Up in the sky.
I'm that mountain peak.
Oh yes, I am.
I made it.
I've made it.
I'm the world's greatest.
And I'm that little bit.
I'm that little bit.
Oh,
when my back's against the
wall,
what I do not to do it.
Exactly.
I'm emotionally okay today. I have a little red spot. I waxed my eyebrows last night. Do they look good? Actually, Renee Schartner waxed my eyebrows last night. And I waxed Diane Hawkins' eyebrows. You know, she burned my right one, but that's all right. It was my first time. She'll get it the next time. Okay.
we're playing the Bears today. At least that's what they said, like 200 or 300 times, I believe. I think it's kind of etched in my memory for eternity now. Really quite juvenile, if I must say. They're trying to be intimidating.
Hey. All right. Signing off? No. Beanie.
Beanie.
Beanie. Go on.
Hi, this is Diane Hawkins here with Carrie Beanie and her little sister. Beanie, how does it feel to have another week of practice?
Another week of practice. I'm just thrilled to keep playing. You know, practice is practice. We always got to do the little shit.
Oh, well, you know.
Little stuff.
Little stuff, my bad.
We can leave that.
Okay, but we get to keep playing, and that's the important thing.
Going twice? Sending all soul to the CD people.
I mean, yeah, we got JC, Justice Cleveland behind the camera there.
And there's one person to blame for that, and I think you can figure out who that is.
Isn't this JC?
Yeah, that'd be JC, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mr. Big Splash himself.
You know,
I'm the Big Splash. Look at me, look at me. I love the camera.
Unbelievable.
Big Splash, number two.
I guess that's about it. Dan Mirren and 90 FM heard a little. Have a good night.
Hey, what's this?
Oh, what's that? What is that smell?
Look at your foot. It's like it smells your feet. Like
it smells like ass out here.
She goes to Stevens Point, and she came.
Support me, you're too cool.
Yeah, but you get you get motion sickness. So
yeah, I do.
Oh, are you alright?
I'm fine.
Hey, listen.
First time press conference. How did it feel? How did it go for you?
I think I made a fool out of myself.
Yeah, let's just say that if they played it in the exact order of like chronological order of what happened, everybody would be like, what the heck is she talking about? Because I got up there and I'm like, they ask me a question, I go, I don't know what to say. The exact words, I don't know what to say. But I know what to say now.
What do you have to say after that?
We won.
Holler.
Somebody to lead me down. Make your call on me, brother. When you need a hand, we all need somebody to lead me down. I just might have a problem that you may not understand. We all need somebody to lean on. Lean on me. When you're not strong, I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry you.
You
won't get home. I'm gonna need somebody to lean.